rail driver. Mama says that I never, never mind her. Got no brains, I'm insane. The teacher says that I'm one big brain.
Hey, welcome back to Brock's Garage. Hey, man, thanks for the ride, John.
Hey, no problem.
That brings back memories,
it
man.
It does.
I haven't been in this truck since the 90s or something.
Yeah, man. Probably 20-some years, dude.
It's been a long, long time. And we used to go cruising all the time with this thing, man. I mean,
right.
This is a 79 Ford Courier.
Yep.
Had a little bit of custom stuff doing it, right?
Right, right.
Obviously.
84 grill and 80 bed, some newer doors. And then the roof that I have at home, I had to get off an 82 because this had a rusted one and it's sunroof. So I had to cut all that to make it fit.
Mm-hmm. So what made you want to do this to the truck? I mean,
mini trucks are kind of hot back in the day. And my dad bought a 76, the earlier style, brand new, biggest piece of crap we ever owned. Swore I'd never own one.
Uh-huh.
And then I worked with these guys that had several lowrider couriers, and I'm like, dude, that looks sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And then I found out you get them with the 2.3 liter Ford, not the junky Mazda motor. I was hooked then.
Mm-hmm.
So I put the whole thing together for little money.
Wow, this thing still looks cool even today. I mean, like I said, we went cruising in this all the time.
Right.
When we had the car club and just a few customs and all that. And
right.
This is one of the featured things we had back then.
Mm-hmm.
I got to tell you, we fit a little different back in the 90s than we did just now.
Yes.
But you really slammed this thing to the weeds too, man.
Right, and it's static. It rides that way. It's no airbags. We didn't have none of that back then.
Well, it's cool. It's a cool truck. You got a killer system in it. So, hey, John, I noticed you put some wheel trim on this that you didn't have before. That looks pretty cool.
Right, right. I was surprised I was still able to get a set of them.
Yeah, that looks good. Yeah, the interior of this is really cool, too. What kind of seats are these?
These seats are out of a wrecked 1980 Mazda RX-7. I picked them up for like $40 at Pick Apart. They don't fit as well as the bench, but they're a lot cooler.
Yeah, man.
That's the reason we don't fit any better either.
a lot of good times in this.
Yeah, and I built
cover.
The console and
did great,
the dash
man.
Custom and the speakers a whole bit.
Tonneau cover looks good still.
Yep, still looking good.
Yep, and you got your French stand antennas.
Oh, you
that
bet.
Was one of your things.
Yep.
That was really cool. Well, I really like the lights you got in this, John.
Yeah, I got some more stuff in the works. I got to build filler panels, box that all in, and I got the Cadillac buckets to put the Cadillac lights back in there. Like we did the Purple Rain. Mm-hmm. I did that on kind of a trial run, and we got some in the works for the cameraman's truck, put some of them in there, get him looking smooth like this.
Yeah, that'd be
old
nice.
Pan, yeah.
That'd look good.
Get him looking good.
Well, we're going to show these guys what we did a little bit earlier on the Chevelle. We did some stuff, so we got some stuff to show you on the Chevelle. Come on. So, thanks to D&M Embroidering, it now is Brock's Garage. Thanks, appreciate it, you guys. So, hey, Look what we got going on the Chevelle. So yeah, man, thanks to John, our master fabricator, we got some lines made up. Had to move some stuff, like this proportioning valve had to be moved up a little bit, but thanks to you, we got that. I appreciate that, man.
Bent some lines, flared them, put the special fittings in, got it all routed right. Should work out good.
Thanks to you for having the right tools, too.
That Yeah, and we'll show you here in a minute how we did that with the Eastwood flaring tool, which is awesome, very expensive, but worth doing it if you got to do any of these at all.
Yeah, the big friggin' hammer didn't.
No, it just chipped the paint. But the hammer, you got to have a hammer.
Yeah. No, it's gonna turn out good, man. I think that the headers and everything we got are gonna fit right by there. I think
we will find out.
It's gonna be in the next episode. I hope we'll find out. So. Yeah, looking good, man.
We have a motor first.
It's coming next episode.
Okay.
Working on it.
You got tires. Yes.
Yeah.
Looking
good. I got
some
old school rallies, man. What do you think?
Yeah, I like them. They look good.
Got some 50s on the back. What do you think of those things, man?
Oh, hell yeah. It's looking good. They're offset, too.
Yep.
50s. Yep, reversed.
10-inch tires on the back.
Oh, yeah. That looks good. Nothing like a steel wheel when you bring it out.
Yeah.
Give it a little attitude, but yet still look stock.
Yeah, I got to paint it the same color as the car when I get that far.
But that should look good with the thin trim ring, center cap painted. Yeah, that's going to look sweet.
Great. Yeah, it's going to look awesome, man. What do you think of this interior that Joe did?
Oh, shit. Joe did the back seat, too.
Joe Mendez, yeah.
Yeah, he did a good work. I'm going to have to do some on the Courier, too, I think. We talked about
yesterday. He started with nothing, man. I pretty much gave him just springs, and he came up with this. He did a really good job on him, I thought.
Yeah, I plan to have him do some on mine, too.
He did a really good job, I thought. So, yeah, man, it's really coming together.
Mm-hmm.
Every day, a little bit of something, you know?
Yep. Be really good when it gets motor and paint in it.
Yeah, I know. Really, I can't wait. So, hey, to everybody out there, keep checking us out, hitting the subscribe button, and watching and hitting the like button, man. We appreciate it. We got some swag. Thanks to D&M Embroidering. Got some cool stuff like keychains and things. So, shirts, whatever you want, man. We got it coming. I appreciate those guys a lot. They really have been helping us out a lot. But keep hitting the like button. Keep checking us out. The Chevelle's getting going. So, hey, we'll catch you guys next time at Brock's Garage.